Welcome back to our intermediate financial accounting class. Over the last few segments, we've been talking about inventory, what it is, why it's important, and how to track it. We've talked about all the different options companies have: periodic, perpetual, LIFO, FIFO, weighted average, and we've done some examples of all of those common inventory methods. Now, in the last segment and in this segment, we're transitioning to a newer method called dollar value LIFO. In the last segment, we talked about what it is, and we talked about how to do the first part of the process by calculating a price index. Now we get to talk about the rest of it. And I should say, as we get started here, because dollar value LIFO has become so common, the steps on how to do it are one of our key concepts. So please make sure you're comfortable with these as we move forward. So here are our steps to the dollar value LIFO method. First, we're going to calculate the value of inventory at each end of year price. So I'm not keeping track of all of my values and inventory going in and out at all. I'm just saying, okay, at the end of the year, if I were to buy all this stuff, it would have cost me this much at my current prices. That's step one. Step two, we're going to calculate the value of the inventory back at the base year. So if I had purchased all this stuff back when I started dollar value LIFO in my base year, what would it have cost me then? And the easy way to do that, instead of going through all of my inventory and recalculating it, is to use the price index that we calculated last time. We simply take the current value price and divide by the price index, and that'll do it. That'll deflate the value from this year's price to our base year price. Third, we're going to calculate the value of any new layer of inventory by looking at the previous layers. Now, before we get into the step, you have to remember the concepts of layers. Do you remember? LIFO layers are all the old inventory that have built up over time. So I bought a bunch of units at $10 each. That's one layer. Then I bought some units at $12 each. They're a little newer. Then some units at $15 each and $20 each and $50 each or whatever. And each of those layers slowly builds up as we don't sell everything we buy. And that's what we're talking about here. We look at all the old layers that we've already shown. Hey, these layers are already in there. Now there's a new layer that I'm adding. Now, probably the best way to think about this, believe it or not, is to think about ice cream. I know, that seems really weird, but it really is a good way to think about this process. Do you remember when you were a kid getting that double-decker ice cream cone where they put two scoops on your cone? And maybe you dreamed like I did of three or four scoops and in this huge tower of ice cream. You probably saw the cartoons or Sesame Street characters with these big, long, or big, tall stacks of ice cream. Well, the same idea is what we're using here in dollar value LIFO. So imagine we've got an ice cream cone, and I go back to my base year prices, and I realize that I have this much ice cream at base year price. That's my total. And then I go back and I take a look and I say, well, I have this much ice cream from the first year. That's my first level. And I have this much ice cream or inventory from the second year. And I have this much inventory from the year after that. And I have this much inventory from last year. So this year I must have added that scoop of ice cream. That is step three. Is going back through all the other scoops of ice cream or layers of inventory, figuring out what's already there. Because remember, it's LIFO, so we assume all the old ice cream is still there. We're just eating from the top down. So I figure out, at the end of the year, I've got this much more ice cream than I did before, so I've added that much of a layer. And now I've got all these different layers of ice cream. And that brings us to step four, where we take each layer and multiply by its price index, and we reinflate from base year prices to the price we actually would have paid in years 1, 2, 3, 4, and then this year, year 5. Finally, our last step is we're going to add up all of those prices at their actual values, what we really paid for that inventory in each of the separate years, and that gives us our ending inventory value now. Pretty cool, huh? Think about it like ice cream, and it makes a lot more sense, I think. At least it does to me. Let's take a look at an example that I hope will solidify this. So with this table, I've done step one for you. These are the end of year prices. This is what I would have paid for all of my inventory if I had purchased it at the end of these years. So this is step one. We're not to the ice cream scoops yet. This is just values at the end of each particular year. Step two is to divide by the price index. And you can see I've calculated this for you as well. And remember, a price index, we call it 100, 110, 115, but it's really 1.0. 1.1, 1.15, etc. So to get to step two, we're going to divide. So 10,000 divided by 1 is still 10,000. 55,000 divided by 1.1 is 50,000. And we could go on and do the rest of these, but let's just pause there and take a look at the value of inventory at these first 2 years. So I'm going to make a table. Tell me, keep track of my dollar value LIFO, and we're going to have a column for year. We're going to have a value at the inventory at the base year price. If you want to think about it this way, this is the total ice cream right here from step two. Next, we're going to have a layers at base year. And these are the scoops of ice cream now. So we've got total ice cream and now the scoops. Then we're going to put back in our price indices. And we're going to multiply the layers at base year times the price index for each year. And that's going to give us our layers at ending prices, or the end of each year. And finally, we'll calculate a total ending inventory. So let's start with year one, the simplest of all. In year one, inventory at base year was 10,000. And you can just imagine, right, in that very first year, I have one scoop of ice cream, and that's all I got. So my layer, my scoops, is just that one scoop, 10,000 units. My price index is 100 or 1.0. So if I multiply 10,000 by 1, I get the same 10,000. And my inventory value would be 10,000, just like that. Year 2 now, my inventory at base year, or the total ice cream, that's what we get from step 2. So it's this number is $50,000. So if we think about our ice cream, I have a $10,000 scoop, and now if my total is $50,000 and I have a $10,000 scoop, then this scoop must be for $40,000. So I have a $40,000 scoop that I'm adding in. My price index for the year is 1.1, so 40,000 times 1.1 is 44,000. So now I have two scoops of ice cream. It cost me $10,000 to buy the first scoop and $44,000 to buy the second scoop, now that I've gotten it back into its actual prices. So my total inventory value at the end of year two is $54,000. That's how Dollar Value LIFO works. Let's take a look at another year. Let's do year three. So I take the $70,000, divide by 1.15, and I get a value of $60,870. So we go back to our table. Year three, let's do our ice cream scoop again. 60,870. I have a $10,000 scoop. I have a $40,000 scoop, and the new scoop, let me put this 60,870 here. So it must be 60,870 minus the 40 minus the 10. So I've added a new layer, or a new scoop of ice cream, of 10,870. If I'd purchased it back when I started Dollar Value LIFO. But I didn't buy it then. Instead, I bought it in year three. So I have to change this price back to the year three prices. So 10,870 times 1.15, or 115, 12,500. If I take the 10 plus the 44 plus the 12,5, my ending inventory at the end of the year, be all three of these, would be 66,500. Now, we've walked through this process three times. Hopefully it's making sense. What I'd like you to do is stop here and do year four, and then come back and check your numbers. Here's our very first two steps. We start with step one. I did that for you, that gave you the $90,000. We take the 90,000 divided by the 1.25, and that gives us a base year value of this $90,000 of inventory of $72,000. That's my total amount of ice cream. So I take that to my other table. 72,000 is my total ice cream. I've got scoops already totaling up to 60,870, all these old layers. So I would have added a new scoop of ice cream of 11,130. I take the 11,130 times the 1.25, that gives me this 13,912. I add all of those ending inventory values together and I end up with a total ending inventory in year four of 80,412. Do you see how this can become really simple? Once you get the hang of it, I'm not keeping track of all those different line items and sales and purchases and in and out. No, it's a very straightforward calculation that I'm just adding in one new line each time I add a layer. Now, the other thing we need to look at here is sometimes we don't keep all of our ice cream. So I've had four scoops and now I eat the top two. So I've dropped the value of my inventory quite a bit. I'm liquidating my layers. And we talked about how companies might do that purposely or unintentionally, and that gives them a higher net income because they're using up this older stuff that we paid less for. Same thing can happen with dollar value. We can liquidate the layers. And we need to take a look at what happens when we end up with less ice cream than we started with. Let's take a look at year five. We take the 95,000 divided by the 135 and we end up with 70,370. You can see right away value has dropped. We were at 72, now we're down to 70,370. Obviously, we've eaten some of our ice cream. So let's take a look at our table here in year five. Put in our 70,370, and let's take a look at our ice cream scoop here. So we started the period with 10,000, 40,000, 10,087, and 11,130. And now I go to measure my ice cream and I realize I'm right here at 70,370. Well, because it's LIFO, this ice cream is still here, and this ice cream is still here, and this ice cream is still here, but only part of that ice cream is still there. So I need to show that in my calculation. And the way I do it is by simply dropping the value of the layers that are now gone. So if I had ended up with $9,000, then I would have dropped my ice cream cone all the way down to here, and I would have said, well, all of this is gone, but I still have this $9,000 scoop of ice cream. So let's take a look at this then. A little bit different at this point. I have to redo the whole table once I start liquidating. You don't have to, but it's usually easier that way. So I still have the $10,000 scoop, and I still have the $40,000 scoop, and I still have this $10,870 scoop. What I don't have is the full 11,130. What have I got instead? Well, the easy way to figure that out is to take 10,000 plus 40 plus 10,870 minus the 70,370. And that gives you the value of this new or this partial ice cream scoop, 9,500. Again, 70,370 minus the scoops I know are still there. So I've dropped this scoop. I still have part of that, but I've dropped it. And I'm going to multiply by my price index. Oh, what price index do I use? It was 135 for this year, but it was 125 for last year. Which of those two numbers do I use? Well, the answer is I use the 125 because that's when I bought it. Not this year's number. I didn't buy anything this year. I don't have a layer or a scoop of ice cream. So I go back to the time when I actually bought it. So 125. And now I can reinflate these. So this stays 10,000 and this becomes 44,000 and this is 12,500 and 9,500 times 1.25 is 11,875. If I add those four numbers up, my total at the prices I actually paid, 78,375. Now, we did an example here. What if I'd liquidated all of my layers up to just $9,000? Well, that would mean that this was gone, and this was gone, and this was gone, and this would go to 9,000. So this would go to 9,000. And that would be 9,000. So same exact process. I just figure out how much ice cream is gone, and I just look for my layers, right? I eat the ice cream from the top down, so what ice cream scoops are left, keep those layers in my process. Now, to kind of round this off, let's add one more year to this, just so we can see what happens after we've done a liquidation. So let's assume, I don't have a lot of space here, but I'm going to try to slip this in. Let's assume that in year six, you had 110,000 and the price index was 140. So let's see, 110 divided by 1.4 gives me 78,571. So I've increased again and added a new scoop of ice cream. So let's go back to our table. Here's year six, 78,571. And I've got all these red marks, but we're working with the purple ones. So we still have the 10,000, the 40,000, the 10, the 950, etc. What's the value of my new scoop of ice cream? Well, I take the 78,571 minus all of these values, or you can draw out your ice cream, whatever works best for you, and I end up with a new value of 8201. That's the new scoop of ice cream. One really important rule here is that once a layer is gone, it's gone. You can't get it back. Just like eating ice cream. Once you've eaten it, it's not coming back onto your ice cream cone. It's gone. You've used it up. So same idea here. So I can't say, well, I've got $8,200 here as my new layer. Why don't I take that $9,500 and kick it back up to the 11,130 first, and then I'll add a new scoop of ice cream? Can't do that. I have to just add a brand new scoop on top of this now smaller scoop that I made by eating or liquidating part of that layer. So in this case, I take the 8201 times not the 135 from year five. That year is gone. I didn't add a layer. I'll never use its price index again. I use the new year's price index. So I'm going to take the 8201 times the 140, and I'm going to get 11,481, give or take a little bit, because I'm rounding. But if I take the 78,375 from last year, I add that 11,480, I get 89,855. And that's my new ending inventory value. That wraps up our Dollar Value LIFO example. Hopefully you can see here how easy this is. When I add a layer, it's just a quick calculation and I'm done. It can be very fast to use this method. Once you get the hang of it, it's even faster when you start to liquidate layers. Certainly faster than using a normal perpetual inventory system and keeping track of every dollar in and out and back and forth. So this has become a popular and common method. When we come back, we're going to wrap up our discussion of inventory. We've done all these examples, all these neat ideas. It's time that we wrap this up. So I will see you then.